In case a Kruskal Wallis test turns out to be significant, it is of interest to the researcher between which of the group's differences can be observed. To achieve this, pairwise comparisons are being used. This can either be done using Wilcoxon tests or Dunn's tests. The latter is preferred though, because it performs better when you have tied ranks, which is more likely the larger your sample is. In order to calculate Dunn's test, we load up the rstatix package with the installed packages and library functions. Now I have access to the Dunn underscore test function. Simply put the dependent variable first, add the tilde, the small wave symbol, and finally the group variable. Add the argument data equals to specify in which data frame your variables are. Finally, the pAdjust method argument is required to counter the alpha error inflation caused by multiple pairwise comparisons. The easiest and also most conservative one is Bonferroni, where your p-value will be multiplied with the number of pairwise comparisons being done. Other methods like Holm, FDR and so forth can be found in the documentation of the Dunn underscore test function and used accordingly. Albeit, your choice needs to be justified, at least with research field specific standards. Eventually, we get a table that shows all pairwise comparisons. In the last two columns, their respective adjusted p-values are shown as well as significance indicators on the 5% alpha level. In my example, I can observe differences between the control group and meditation group, as well as between the control group and mentoring group. The mentoring and meditation group have a p-value some might still consider for further investigation and or interpretation. Please consult the paper, the ASA statement on p-values and draw your own conclusions. Finally, you might have a significant Kruskal Wallis test and no low enough p-values in post-hoc testing when controlling for alpha error inflation. Just keep in mind that a p-value, to which it all boils down to, is simply a function of sample size, which decreases with an increase in sample size for any effect size that is different from zero. So a non-significant test result in almost all cases tells you you're lacking statistical power as a result of too small of a sample. Don't, and I repeat, please don't use post-hoc power analysis to justify your non-findings, because the observed power is a one-to-one function of the p-value. After doing a post-hoc test, you should calculate the effect sizes for observed differences, which is shown in the following video.